A very good morning to everyone. Today we'll discuss exercise 2D of second chapter. Right? It is based upon how we can expand the decimals, how we can convert the decimals into fraction, how we can convert fraction into the decimals. Okay? Then how we can add, subtract, multiply, divide the decimals. These all things we'll discuss by today in the class. And we'll discuss these things also, how we can compare. Okay, how you can check it out, that this is smaller decimal, this is bigger decimal, this is the ascending order, this is the descending order, right? These all things we'll discuss by today in the class. Okay, now let's start with the question 1. Please understand very, very carefully. Each question is based upon different concept. Okay, each question is based upon different concept. I'll tell you one part, and one part you will do at home. Right? So see and understand very carefully. First question is expanded form. How we can expand the terms? Right? So suppose this is the question 216. How you used to expand? If without decimal the question is given to you, how you can expand the term? You will expand in this way: 2 multiplied by 100, 1 multiplied by 10 plus 6. In this way, you used to expand. Okay, but if the question is given to you in decimal form, suppose 0.53 is given. 0.53 is given. So you have to write in this way: plus 5 divided by 10, 3 divided by 100, in this way. Okay, suppose 1.7963 is given. So 1 will be 1 plus 7 divided by 10. After decimal, whenever your first number will come, that digit you have divided with 10. Other number you divide with 100, third with 1000, fourth with 10,000, up to so on. Okay, plus 9 divided by 100, plus 6 divided by 1000, plus 3 divided by 10,000. In this way, we used to expand the decimal into the expanded form. Is it clear to everyone? Now let's start with the question, with the part 1. Okay, your first question is, First part is 0.029. So how we can write in this way? 0 will be 0 plus this 0 divided by 10. Okay, you can write or you can remove this. Okay, it's your choice. Plus 2 divided by 100 plus 9 divided by 1000. This is your expanded form. Any doubt is there in the expanded form? Sure? Okay. Now, let's start with the third part. Second part you will do at home. Third part. 589.374. Okay. 5 multiplied by 100. 8 multiplied by 10. Plus 9 multiplied by 1. Plus 3 divided by 10 plus 7 divided by 100 plus 4 divided by 1000. This will be your answer. Okay? Alright? Before decimal, the way you are expanded the term, the same way you have to expand. After decimal, you have to divide the first term with 10, second term with 100, third term with 1000, up to so on. Right? Just wait. Let me read the queries. No, Shaurya, up to here is your answer. Okay, no need to divide. No need to divide. Just you have to show in this way. Okay, you have to show that here we, before decimal, we used to multiply. After decimal, we used to divide. That's it. Okay? It's clear to everyone? Okay. Okay, now for second part I'm giving you for the homework. Now, second question. Second question is arranging the decimals into ascending order. First of all, tell me, what do you mean by ascending order? Ascending order. What is ascending order? Ascending order is, please tell me, bigger to smaller or smaller to bigger? Very good. Very good. All are giving correct answer. Very good. Ascending order is smaller to bigger. Okay. We used to start with smaller number to the higher number. Higher, or we can say the bigger number. Okay. We used to start in this way. Right. Okay. Hazel, please adjust your camera. Now, question second, first part. First part is 6.92, 0.87, 1.93, 5.6. Please tell me which is the smaller among all these. Which is the smallest? This is 6 point something, 0 point something, 1 point something, 5 point something. Obviously, 0.87 is smaller. After that, very good. After that, 1.93. After that, obviously, 5.6. Very good. After that, last is 6.92. Right? So this is your answer. In this way, you have to write in the ascending order. That's it. Is it clear? This question is clear to everyone. How we can write in the ascending order? Okay, Hazel. Other students. Other students. Okay. Yash Sharma, seventh blossom. Your video is paused. Kindly see to it. Second part I'm giving you for the homework. Will you do by on? Second part I'm giving you for the homework. Okay? Please tick second part. You have to write same as it is. Ascending order, smaller to the higher. Right? Okay. Now I'm doing now third question. Third question I'm going to start. Third question is descending order. Please tell me the meaning of descending order first of all. Descending order. Yes, everyone. Smaller to bigger or bigger to smaller? Sanchit, Ananya, very good. Prasan, Shaurya, Naman, Hazel, very good. Disha, very good. Geet, very good. It is bigger to smaller. Bigger to smaller. Okay. I am writing here first part. Second part I am giving you for the homework. First part is 0.98, 9.8, 8.9, 4.57, 8.03. Okay, these are the numbers given to you. Okay, which is the bigger number? 0 point something, 9 point, 8 point, 4 point, 8 point. Which is? Very good, Hazel. 9.8 is the bigger number. Very good. Yes, Tanvi, very good. Next will be what? 8.9 or 8.03? Please tell me first of all which is the bigger. 8.88 is same. Now check it out after decimal. 9 is there, here 0 is there. So 9 is bigger, obviously. Okay? So 8.9, then 8.03. After that, yes, 4 point. Very good. 4.57. After that, last one is done all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 is left. Which is left? 0.98. Okay, 0.98. Right? So this is the order of the descending. Okay, bigger to smaller. Right? Okay. Now, second part, please click the second part. This is the homework. Second part is the homework. Quickly. This exercise is very easy. Okay. Just you have to understand the concept. Sit properly in the class. Tanvi, sit properly. Fourth question is, convert each of the decimal into fraction. Okay. And in the simplest form. first question is given 0.02. First of all, how I can convert into the decimal? How I can convert decimal into the fraction? You have to remove the decimal. Okay. After decimal, what is the term in the numerator? 002. And decimal is there before two digits. So here you have to divide with 100. Divide with 100. You know very well. You have to remove the decimal. Decimal is there before two digits. So in the denominator, you have to multiply with 100. Okay. After that, you can write this question in this way also. 002 means 2 divided by 100. 002 means 2 only. 2 divided by 100. Now you can cancel it or not. Yes, you can cancel also, because they have asked in the question. You can reduce in the lowest form. 2 ones are, 2 fives are, and 0. That is equals to 1 upon 50 is your answer. 1 upon 50 is the answer. Saloni, very good. Any doubt is there? Sure? Okay. Suppose now I am going to do third part. Third part is 0.003. Okay, decimal is there before three digits. Okay, remove decimal. So it will be 003 divided by, decimal is there before three digits, to divide with 1000. Divide with 1000. Or you can write in this way, 0003 is equals to only 3 divided by 1000. Now I can't cancel 3 with 1000. Okay, I can't reduce into the further smallest form. Okay, I can't reduce. So this is my answer. Some are writing answer in decimal. No, you don't have to divide, because already you have converted decimal into fraction. Question is, you have to convert the decimal into fraction. Or if you can cancel the fraction, then you can reduce into the lowest form also. Otherwise, up to here is your answer. Is it clear to everyone? Okay. Now, second part and fourth part is your homework. Quickly mark these parts. Now question fifth, you have to convert into the mixed fraction. Okay, mixed fraction. I am doing third part. Mixed fraction. Third part is 3.125. First of all, remove the decimal. Okay, it will be 3125 divided by 1000. Divided by 1000. Okay. Now, you can cancel on 5 table. 5 2s are 0, 0. 5 6s are 30. 5 2s are 10. 5 5s are 25. Again, on 5 table, 5 1s are 5. 5 2s are 10. 5 5s are. 5 4s are and 0. 5 2s are 10. 5s are. 5 8s are. Now, what is left? 25 divided by 8. Okay, this is the fraction. You have to convert into the mixed fraction. So divide it. Divide with 8. 8 threes are 24. What is left? 1 is left. So how we can write? How we can write? This 3 will come here. Okay. This 8 will go in the. How, tell me how we can write. 8 will come here. Okay. And this will go here. This is the mixed fraction. Okay. 25 upon 8. You have to write 25 upon 8 in this way. Okay. Into the mixed fraction. This is your answer. This is your answer. In third question, you have to remove decimal. And after removing decimal, change into the fraction. After converting into the fraction, if you can cancel it, then you can cancel the terms. Okay. Now this is the fraction which is left. Now you have to divide this fraction and take out your answer in the mixed fraction. Any doubt is there in this fifth question? It is very easy. You are doing from the very previous grades. Any doubt is there? Mavish? just wait, let me check your queries. Kavya, they have asked in the question that you have taken your answer in mixed fraction. That's why I have converted. Right? Bigger digits. See, this we can cancel on 5 table. Very easily. Okay, you can cancel on 5 table. Remove decimal. In the denominator, 1000 will come. Then I have cancelled on 5 table. Okay. Now 25 upon 8. Now this I can't cancel. So you have to write 25 upon 8. Now divide it and take out your answer in mixed fraction. Okay. Gurveer. Division part. Division, this one. 5 2s are 10. 0 0. 5 6s are 30. And 1 will left. Then 5 2s are 10. Then 2 is left. Then 5 5s are 25. Okay, 625. Now 625 again we can cancel on 5 table. 5 1s are 1 is left. 5 2s are 10. 2 is left. 5 5s are 25. And here 5 4s are 20 and 0. Now at the last 5 8s are 40. 5 2s are 10. 2 is left. 5s are 25. So 25 upon 8 is left. Divide it and take out the answer in mixed fraction. Fine. Yanya, by today morning you got the PDF. Okay, rest of the PDF, you know that on which days you are getting the PDF according to subject wise. Right, now let's start with the next question. In the fifth question, you have to convert into the fraction and then take out in the mixed fraction. Priyansh, seventh awesome. Adjust your camera quickly. Now we are going to start sixth question. Convert into the decimals. Okay, suppose I am doing this first part. 17 upon 20. So can you do this? Division, can you do this? It is very easy. You have to divide. Okay, how we can divide? 17 will be here, 20 will be here. It is not going. Okay, so I'll put here 0 and decimal. So I'll write here 0. Okay, I'll write here 0. Okay, so how? On which table it will go now? 20. How much? Yes, 20 8s. Okay, 20 into 8, that is 160. 10 is left. Okay, now again 0 and it is going on. 20 5s are 100. So your answer will be equals to 0.8. How much? 0.8? Yes. Yes, 0.85. This is your answer. Right? Any doubt is there? Please check it out. I have just simply done the division. This will come inside. This you have to write here. 20 divided with this. You have to write 0 here and put decimal. After keeping decimal here, then you can place 0 here. Now it is going on 20 8s are 160. 10 is left, then 20 5s are 100. Okay. Priyansh Joshi. Priyansh, take your seat properly. What, Sanchit? Just wait. Yeah, that also you can do, Sanchit. Hazel, that also you can do. You can do in that, with that method also. Okay, I'll tell you that method also. Some students are asking, ma'am, can we apply the multiplication method? Yes, you can apply. You can go with the simple division also. It is also very easy. This division you are doing from your first, second grade. Okay, otherwise you can go with the with this method. I have to multiply with which number so that here 100 will come? Please tell me. I'll multiply with which number so that 100 will come? 5 here, and you have to multiply 5 here also. Okay, I'll tell you. If I multiply here with 5, it will be 100. If I multiply this with 5, it will be how much? It will be how much? 17 5s are? 17 5s are how much? Yes, yes, yes. 85, yes. Yes, okay. So 85 divided by 100, okay. See, in this way you can also do your, you can convert your fraction into decimal. Whatever is the denominator given to you, you have to multiply with that number so that 100, 1000, 10,000, 10 will come. Okay? So I am going to multiply with 5. If I multiply 5 here, you have to multiply 5 in the numerator as well. 17 5 is 85, 20 5 is 100. So my answer will be, how I can write in this way? 8 and 5 will be here, divide by 100 is there. That means before 2 digits, your decimal will come. Both answers are same as it is. You can go with the division or you can go with this method. Right? Okay, I'm doing one more question. You will be able to understand more easily then. Suppose, fourth question is given. Check it out, your fourth question. Check your book side by side. Yanya, are you getting all the points? You are busy somewhere. Fourth question, fourth part is 2317 divided by 1000. Okay, here in the denominator already 1000 is given. Already 1000 is given. So no need to convert into 1000, 100 or anything. So you can easily write this fraction into the decimal. 2317. Here 1000 is there. So it means before 3 digits, you have to place a decimal. Any doubt? Any doubt in this question? This is very easy. Okay, now I will solve one more part. Yeah, 7th part. 7th part, 14, 1 upon 25. 14, 1 upon 25. First of all, multiply 14 with 25 quickly. 14 into 25, quickly do multiplication and tell me the answer. 14 into 25, 350 plus 1, plus 1, 351. Very good, Sanchit. Ananya, very good. Divided by 25. Now look here, I have converted the mixed fraction into the fraction. Now, I want in the denominator here 100 will come. 100, 1000 or 10,000, whatever. So I'll multiply with which number? Numerator and denominator, I'll multiply with which number? Very good, Hazel, Geet, Saloni, Yanya, Sanchit, Prasan, Aditya, Ananya, Ayan, very good, Akshit, very good, Siddharth, please tell me the answer. Very good, Anshika, Naman, very good. So I'll multiply with 4 here and 4 here. Okay, 25 into 4, how much? That will be 100. That will be 100. 351 into 4, do it quickly. 351 into 4, yes, very good, 1404. Okay, so it is equals to 1404 divided by 100. So you can easily place decimal. It is equals to 14.04. This is your answer. In this way also you can take out or you can go with the other method, that is division. Okay, you can apply any method. You can simply convert the denominator into 100, 1000, 10,000 by multiplying with the number. If you are multiplying here with 8, then you have to multiply your numerator also with 8. Okay, same number you have to multiply and divide, and then you can easily convert. Any doubt in the sixth question? Any doubt in this question? Please let me know. Everyone. Okay. Right. Now I'm going to start seventh question. Seventh, there are two parts. One part I'm doing. One part you will do at home. Very, very easy it is. Seventh question, first part. You have to convert the decimal into the like decimals. Into the like decimals. Okay. What do you mean by like decimals? Please tell me. Like decimals. I have told you like fractions. Okay. with same denominator. Yes, very good. Decimals, decimal, like decimals. That you are saying, Hazel, you are saying regarding the fraction. Okay, like decimals. See, I'm writing here 2.9 and I'm writing here 3.60. Okay, what are the like decimals? After decimal, there should be same number of digits. Here also it should be same number of digits. Okay, so if I want to convert both into like fraction, like decimals, how I can convert? Here I'm having, check it out, the highest. Here I'm having two digits after decimal. So here also I'll put 10 so that it will be equal. It will be equal. Right? Here I'm having now two digits. Here I'm having now two digits. So these are like decimals. Okay, like decimals are, after decimal there should be equal number of digits. There should be equal number of digits. Right? Harman's seventh awesome. Harman's seventh awesome. I'm watching whatever you are doing in the class. Okay? Okay, now I'm going to start first part. That is 5.8. These are the numbers given to you. 19.07, 0.296, 118.1. Check it out, after decimal which is having the highest number of digits. After decimal which is having highest number of digits. Very good. This is, it is having three digits. Others are having two or one. Okay. So you have to make, after decimal each number is having a three digits. So how I can make? It will be 5.800. Now how many digits are there? Three digits. Okay. Second number, 19.070. Again, how many? Three digits are there. It is already having, this is having three digits. It will be as it is. And last will be 118.100. So this is having three digits. Okay? It's understood to everyone? Check it out, which is having the highest number of digits after decimal. Okay? If it is having 3, 4, 5, then you have to make every digit, every number should be having 5 or 4 or 3 digits after the decimal. Okay? By placing 00, that's it. You just have to place number of zeros. Okay? Now it is having 3, 3, 3 and 3. It's clear? Alright. So let's start. Second part is your homework. Now let's start with the question 8. In question 8, you have to convert. It is very, very interesting. Question 8. And very, very important. Question 8. You have to convert. Okay, how we can convert? See, 8th question, first part is 45 paise, you have to convert into rupees. Please tell me, 1 paisa is having how much rupees? How many rupees are there in 1 paisa? Sanchit, very good. Hazel, very good. Ananya, Anirudh, Prasan, very good. Adarsh Lathar, sit straight in the class. Take out the wire from the mouth. Aditya, very good. Harman, Abhijot, very good. Pratishtha, give me answer. Geet, very good. Yes, yes. So how you can convert? 1 paisa is having, 1 paisa is equals to how much? 1/100 rupees. Okay, so you have to divide with 100. That's it. So it will be equals to 45 divided by 100. That is your answer. Okay. Second is 9 centimeter you have to convert into meter. Please tell me, I'll divide with what? 9 centimeter, I'll divide with how much? Hazel, Prasan, Saloni, Tanveep, very good, Abhijot, very good. See, in the first question, you can leave your answer up to here also, or you can take out in decimal also. Okay, it's absolutely fine. Okay, because teacher has to check only how much, with how many zeros you are going to divide. Okay, we'll check only this thing. It should be correct. Okay, now 9 centimeter, we'll write here 9 divided by 100. Okay, a centimeter is having, when we convert centimeter into meter, we have divided with 100. Right, now this is the third part is 2.7 millimeter you have to convert into centimeter. It's very very easy. You have divided with how much? Divide with, very good Siddharth, Prasan, you divide with 10, so it will be 2.7. okay, 2.7 divided with 10, that will be equals to, it will be equals to 0.27 centimeter. You have to write your answer up to here, no worries. Up to here, no worries. It's absolutely correct. Okay, now all the parts I'll not do. I'm doing now fifth part. Some parts you have to try at home. It's very very easy. Fifth part is 30 minutes you have to convert into hour. Please tell me 30, I'll divide 30 with how much? 1 minute is having how many hours? Very good. Very good. Ananya, no. Others, yes, correct. Kushan, seventh, awesome. What you are doing? Give me answer properly. Yes, it is divided with 60. Okay, so you can write your answer up to here, or you can remove 0, 0. Then 3 ones are, 2s are. So your answer will be 1 by 2 hour. So obviously 30 minutes always equals to half an hour. You know that 30 minutes always equals to half an hour. Okay, or you can write it up to in this way, 0.5 hour, 1 by 2 hour or 0.5 hours. Okay, now next part is I'm doing now last part, eighth part is 15 meter 17 centimeter. Okay, convert it into the meter. How we can convert? First of all, 15 meter and 17 centimeter, convert into the centimeter. It will be equal to 15, 17 centimeter. Okay, you have to add. Right, so 15 meter 17 centimeter, it will be equal to 1517. Now convert into the meter, 1517 divided by 100. Okay, we have done earlier also, when we are converting centimeter into the meter, you divide with 100. So you can leave your answer up to here, or you can write 15.17 meter up to here also. It's correct to everyone, it's visible to everyone. Okay. Fine, Abhijot, Sanchet, Angel, right? Now this is your 8th question. Now I'm going to start 9th question. Today we'll discuss up to 10th question, okay? Both are very very easy. 9th and 10th, again, both are very very easy. Only one formula you have to apply in 9th and one in 10th. 9th question, you have to convert all the parts into the kilogram. You have to convert all the parts into the kilogram. Right? Now see to it. Suppose I am doing first part. First part is 50 gram. How you will convert 50 gram into kg? 50 gram into kg with how many zeros you will divide? Very good, Yanya. Prasan. You have divided with 1000. Okay, 50 divided with 1000. Okay, 5 ones are, 5 twos are 0, 1 by 20, or you can take out your answer in decimal also. Up to here also, your answer is absolutely correct. 1 upon 20 kg. Up to here also, answer is absolutely correct. Okay, suppose I am doing now fourth part. 7 kg, 5 gram. Now how I can convert 5 kg and 5 gram? It is equals to how much? It is equals to It is equals to how much? Very good, Sanchit. Very good. It is equals to 7,000 kg plus 7,000 gram plus 5 gram. That is equals to 7,005 gram. Now convert into the kilogram. Into the kilogram, then you have to divide with 1,000. Okay? So your answer will be equals to how much? Answer will be equals to 7.005 kilogram. First of all, convert this into the gram and then this gram into the kilogram. Right? Avni and Hargun, 7th Florence. Sit attentive in the class. Yes, Angel, very good. Now, last 10th question is, in 10th question, you have to express the rupees into the using decimals. Okay, now see how we can convert 10th question. You have to convert into the rupees. Okay, convert into the rupees. Right, your first part is 5 paise. How we can convert 5 paise into the rupees? How we can divide? With how much we can divide? We have done first part in the previous question. Very good, Siddharth, Ananya, Sanchit, Tanvi. 5 divided by 100. Okay, so you can write your answer. 1 upon 20 rupees. Or you can take out your answer in decimals also. They are saying yes, take out answer into the decimals. So in decimal, your answer will be equals to how much? 1 divided by 20. How much it will be? 1 divided by 20. Take out the decimals quickly. 0.05. Very good. 0.05. This is your answer. Okay. Suppose I'm doing now third part. Last. This is last part I'm doing now. Please look here properly. Today your homework is up to question 10th. Whatever parts I have given you for the homework. 55 paise. Okay. So how we can write 55 rupees plus 55 divided by 100. Okay. This is already in rupees. This paisa you have to divide with 100. So it is equals to how much? 55 plus 0.55. Or it is equals to 55.0.55. Yes or no?